Kanye West, invented in 1977 by Donda West. Kanye West was born in Atlanta, Georgia, after God announced to his mother that she would give virgin birth to the savior of hip-hop. Having also heard the news of the soon-to-be-birthed king of hip-hop, three wise niggas traveled from New Jersey to Atlanta to bestow gifts upon their new king. A gold Jesus piece, a Louis Vuitton scarf, and the keys to a Mercedes-Benz 300 SLR are all gifted to baby Kanye. Another group also catches word of the birth of a new king of hip-hop, the Furious Five and their leader Grandmaster Flash. Grandmaster Flash orders the execution of every newborn baby in Georgia in an attempt to prevent a new king from rising up. This attempt on baby Kanye's life failed, as his mother was able to successfully flee from Atlanta to Chicago, avoiding the Grandmaster's wrath. Now, before we begin, I should state, if you're here to listen to me bash Kanye over his recent antics, then you're going to be thoroughly disappointed. I love Kanye. He's one of my biggest idols. He's up there with Dave Chappelle, Chad Johnson, Elon Musk, and of course, the biggest inspiration of them all, Lil B. Thank you, Bass God. Now, what do all these successful, inspirational black men all have in common? Well, obviously they've all done great things, but sometimes they also make mistakes. Dave Chappelle decided to get absolutely blitzed out of his skull before one of his sets. I'm sure Ocho Cinco has dropped a pass or two. Elon Musk hasn't yet used his immense power and resources to wipe out humanity. And Lil B... Anyway, today we're going to go through Kanye's discography and also certain events in his life in order to keep a running tally of his achievements and mistakes and see what kind of life he has lived. Let's begin with College Dropout, Kanye's debut album. Kanye struggled to secure a record deal to release this album due to him not fitting in with the general gangsta persona that dominated the rap game at the time. When he finally managed to secure a record deal, Kanye released College Dropout to widespread critical acclaim and commercial success, and became the first musical artist to win the Grammy's Lifetime Achievement Award off of their debut record. This act of breaking the mold and not conforming to what others have done, and finding a style that is 100% unique to you, never been done before, is something that I have personally taken to heart with my own YouTube channel. The most inspiring piece of music off the album was its lead single, Jesus Walks, which was recorded 2 weeks after Kanye West was killed in a car accident, and then subsequently resurrected. Kanye was dead, laid out in a tomb, and he came back to life and immediately said fuck it and started releasing music. This sets the tone for this man's entire music career. He does not give a single fuck and will do whatever the fuck he wants. Moving on to Kanye's second album, Late Registration. This album is very good, but ignoring it almost completely, I'm going to focus on two events in Kanye's life. The first being before the release of the album, when Kanye failed to complete the treble at the 2004 American Music Awards. He won the I Got a Lot of Cheese Award and the Nigga Please Award, but failed to secure the Best New Artist Award, losing out to Gretchen Wilson.
Who the fuck is Gretchen Wilson?
Right? That's exactly what Kanye was thinking when he was burning down the Shrine Auditorium. Kanye was then arrested for arson and the release date for his album was pushed back a year. In 2005, the album released and did very well, being generally regarded as the only good album to come out that year. Shortly after the release of this album, Kanye foreshadows his entry into politics with one single statement.
George Bush doesn't care about black people.
This act of shit-talking the leader of the Republican Party, and his display of being able to handle complicated sensitive issues by single-handedly defusing the Jay-Z and Nas beef, endeared Kanye to the Democratic Party. After going against the grain of the hip-hop world with his debut album, Kanye completes his education-themed trilogy with Graduation, and creates a new grain in the hip-hop world. By winning a 1v1 with 50 Cent, the poster boy of gangster rap, in a game of Uno, Kanye set the stage for other rappers without a gangsta image to make their way to the top of the rap game. Having entered as an outsider, quickly rising through the ranks, becoming king of the rap game, and completing his transformation from Kanye to Yeezy, Yeezy decides to take his talent for dominance to another field, 808s and tax breaks. This album details Yeezy's political campaign to secure victory in the 2008 US presidential election over John McCain. Yeezy with his two running mates, Jeezy and Weezy, dominated the election. Despite winning the Electoral College and the popular vote by a very large margin, Kanye was forced to abdicate in favor of Barack Obama after he dared to insult a white woman in public. After this transgression, Yeezy, Jeezy, and Weezy are all exiled to the island of Elba. Yeezy managed to escape his exile and traveled to Paris, where he overthrew the local government and ruled Paris as an independent city-state for 100 days. During this time, Yeezy recorded the album Watch the Throne with his best friend Jay-Z. The lead single off the album, Niggas in Paris, detailed Yeezy's rise to power and his time as emperor of the Paris city-state. Eventually, Yeezy was forced into exile again, this time to Hawaii. During his time in Hawaii, Yeezy experimented on the male cast members of Duck Dynasty, fusing them into one super being who would become his co-producer on all his future albums, the first of which was My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, Yeezy's magnum opus, which, okay, I don't have any exaggerated story or jokes for this one, I just really like this album. It's probably my favorite hip-hop album of all time. I would legitimately recommend it to anyone who enjoys hip-hop, or music in general. Seriously, it's really good. This shit sounds like it was recorded inside the heart of Kilauea, if you know what I mean. Moving on to Cruel Summer. This album is a documentation of Yeezy spending the summer of 2012 with his closest friends after returning from his exile, living his second life to the fullest before his inevitable downfall. Yeezy knew this would come eventually. From the moment he was brought back to life after that car crash, he knew he would have to return to the void eventually, and with his gradual slip back into the nether beginning, Yeezy began working on Yeezas. Yeezy said fuck it and just sort of did anything he could think of. He listened to Death Grips once and said, yeah, I can do that. He released a track with then relatively unknown musician and fellow resurrectee Paul McCartney, immediately pushing the Brit into superstardom. He had his fourth child with Kim Kardashian, a daughter named North, who along with her brothers and sister now rule over the earth, each governing their respective quadrant. He began his own clothing and shoe line. The man fucking did it all, and we were all fucking loving it. The life of Pablo. At this point, Yeezy fully recognizes that he is losing his grip on reality, and his consciousness will slip from him shortly. So he uses what little time he has left to produce this gospel album, as a thank you to God for implanting him in his mother's womb, and for resurrecting him after the car crash. Now between this album and Yeezy's latest album, Yeezy apparently lost his entire mind. We're talking extreme episodes of psychosis and paranoia, switching political allegiances apparently on a whim, and having a fifth child throwing off the balance created by the other four. Now, so far, Counter has shown zero mistakes, but surely one of these has to be a mistake, right? Wrong. You see, the spirit of Grandmaster Flash was still pissed about losing his throne to Yeezy, so with his mystical ghost powers, he got Kanye addicted to opioids for a short time. And let me tell you take a few hits off that Fenty blunt, who, buddy, you are losing it. Trust me. Trust me. He also said this.
When you hear about slavery for 400 years, for 400 years, that sounds like a choice.
Now, you might think this is a mistake, but if you really think about it, all tragedies and unfortunate events are choices. $200 billion worth of damage in one hurricane season? That sounds like a choice to me. Why do you have so many buildings near the Gulf of Mexico? Just move them to Wyoming. There's nothing there now. It's just land going to waste. The Spanish flu killed 5% of the world's population in 2 years. Sounds like a choice to me. Just wash your hands and don't ever interact with another human being. You'll never get sick again. 400 years of slavery? Sounds like a choice to me. Just don't get on the boat, my man. Or if it's already too late for that, just leave. What are they gonna do, kill you? Look, if you leave, they're down a slave. And if they kill you, they're down a slave. It's a lose-lose situation for them. After this short episode of unfiltered psychosis, Yeezy has managed to recollect his senses just long enough to release Love Everyone. This is Yeezy's latest album, and will be his final album. Yeezy's time to return to the void is upon us, and he leaves us with his final message, Love Everyone. In his final project, Yeezy comes full circle to where he began, working hard against the current wave controlling the hip-hop scene. Currently, SoundCloud rap and mumble rap dominate hip-hop. In this time where meaningful songs and skillful lyricism have been pushed to the sideline, Kanye has the gall to drop this masterpiece on us.
Boop-dee-doo-scoop. Scoop-dee-dee-whoop. Whoop-dee-scoop-dee-poop. Poop-dee-scoop-dee-scoop-dee-whoop. Whoop-dee-scoop-whoop-poop. Poop-dee-dee-whoop-scoop. Poop. Poop. Scoop-dee-dee-whoop. Whoop-dee-dee-scoop. Whoop-dee-dee-scoop-poop.
Absolute genius. Before he goes into that eternal rest, Kanye ushers in a new era of imaginative rhyme schemes, unparalleled flow, and breathtaking storytelling. It's like MF Doom, Big L, and Slick Rick all jizzed into a petri dish and grew a super rap baby in a vat of rap juice. It's glorious, and it's the perfect way to wrap up such an illustrious life and musical career. Honestly, this world does not deserve Yeezy. Look at this stat tracker. Not a single mistake. The man has not made one single misstep on his journey through world domination. If there's one lesson to take from his life, it's this. Opioids are bad for you.
Boop-dee-doo-scoop. Scoop-dee-dee-whoop. Whoop-dee-scoop-dee-poop. Poop-dee-scoop-dee-scoop-dee-whoop.